Good morning, fourth class children. All of you open your mathematics activity book, children. Now, all of you open page number 15, children. Now, see the question, children. Observe the colored parts. Observe the colored parts of the given shapes and note down the fractions. Put the appropriate sign. Greater than, less than, equal to, between them. Okay, children, once again I am reading the question. See, observe the colored parts of the given shapes and note down the fractions. Put the appropriate sign, greater than, less than, or equal to, between them. Okay, children, see, children, here they have given some fractions, children. Now, first, see the first shape. See how many parts first write. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total how many parts do you have, children? 6 parts. Now, how many are colored? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 are colored. Okay. Now, same process right here also. See how many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 are shaded. Okay, children. Now, by observing these two fractions, means here we got denominator 6, here also denominator 6. Both the denominators are equal. So, these two are like fractions. Okay. Now, see the numerators. What are the numerator numbers they have given? 4, 5. So, which is the greatest number? 5 is the greatest number. So, 5 by 6 is the greatest number. Okay. 4 by 6 is greater than 5 by 6. Okay. Now, come to the next one, children. Now, by observing this one, how many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. 3 are shaded. Same process. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many parts do you have? 4. How many are colored? 1 is colored. Okay. See, here also numerators are same. Okay. See the denominators both are same. See the numerators 3, 1. So, which is the greatest one? 3 is the greatest one. So, 3 by 4 is greater than 1 by 4. Now, come to the next sum, children. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are shaded. Now, same process right for the next one also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, total 8 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, 7 are shaded. So, 7 by 8, 7 by 8. Both the numbers are equal. So, keep the symbol equal to symbol. Okay. Now, come to the next one. 1, 2, 3. Total, you are having 3 parts. How many are shaded? 1 is shaded. Next, 1, 2, 3. 3 parts do you have? How many are shaded? 1, 2. 2 are shaded. So, which is the greatest number? 2 is the greatest number. So, we have to keep the symbol for 2 by 3. So, 1 by 3 is less than 2 by 3. Okay? Now, come to the next one, children. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, total parts we have to write in the denominator place, children. 5. How many are shaded? 1, 2. 2 are shaded. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3 are shaded. So, by observing these two, which is the greatest number? 3 is the greatest number. So, keep the symbol for 3 by 5. Okay? 2 by 5 is less than 3 by 5. Okay? Now, come to the next one, children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total how many parts do you have? 7 parts. How many are colored? 1 part is colored. Next, Come to the next figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are shaded. So, which is the greatest number? 1 by 7 or 6 by 7? 6 by 7. Okay, now come to the next one, children. How many parts do you have? 1, 2. How many are shaded? 2 are shaded. So, 2 by 2. Next, here how many parts do you have? 2 parts. How many are shaded? 1 part is shaded. So, by observing these two, which is the greatest number? 2 by 3 is the greatest number. Okay, now come to the next one, children. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total 10 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are shaded. Same process. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total 10 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 are shaded. So, 7, 5. Which is the biggest number? 7 is the biggest number. So, 7 by 4 is greater than 5 by 10. Okay, children, do you understand? Now, all of you turn the page, children. Now, all of you open page number 16, children. See the question, what they are given. Read each question carefully and tick the correct answer. Read each question carefully and tick the correct answer. Okay, children, now what is the question they have given? Which fraction represent the fraction 1 by 2? Which figure represent the fraction 1 by 2? Here they are given two figures, children. By observing these two figures, which one is 1 by 2? See. Here how many parts do you have? 2 parts. How many are shaded? 1. Now same process. How many parts do you have? 2 parts. How many are shaded? 2. So, in the question, what they given? 1 by 2. 1 by 2, where we got it? Yes. So, keep your tick mark. Okay. Now, same process. Come to the next one, children. How many parts do you have? See, first read the question. Which figure represent the fraction 1 by 3? So, here we have to observe 1 by 3, children. So, how many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3. So, total 3 parts. How many are shaded? 1 is shaded. Next, 1, 2. Only you are having 2 parts. How many are shaded? 1 part is shaded. So, in the question, what they given? 1 by 3. Where we got it? Here. Here we got it. So, keep tick mark. Next, come to the next one, children. Which figure represent the fraction 1 by 4? Next, count 1, 2, 3. How many are shaded? 1 part is shaded. Next, here 1, 2, 3, 4, total 4 parts, 1 part is shaded. So, which one is correct? 1 by 4, we got it here. So, keep your tick mark. Now, come to the next one, children. Which figure represent the fraction 3 by 5? Which figure represent the fraction 3 by 5? See, count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. 3 are shaded. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5 parts. How many are shaded? 2 parts are shaded. In the question, what they given? 3 by 5. Where you got it? 3 by 5? Yes, so this figure is correct. Now, come to the next one, children. Which figure represent the fraction 2 by 3? Which figure represent the fraction 2 by 3? Which figure see? 1, 2, 3. Here 3. How many are shaded? 2 are shaded. Next, 1, 2, 3. Next, how many are shaded? 1 is shaded. So, in the question they given 2 by 3. Where we got it 2 by 3? Yes. So, keep tick mark for first one. Next, come to the next one, children. Which figure represent the fraction 3 by 4? Okay. Now, see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. So, answer is 3 by 5. So, same process. Count here. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many are shaded? 3 are shaded. Where we got it? 3 by 4. Here we got it. So, keep tick mark for 3 by 4. Okay, children, you understand? Now come to the next question. Circle the right fraction. Circle the right fraction, which represents the shaded part of each shape. Circle the right fraction, which represent the shaded part of each shape. Okay, children, now first count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 parts. 1 part is shaded. So answer is 1/7. So by observing these 3 numbers, where we got it? 1/7 here, children. So circle that number. Okay. Now come to the next one, children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. 3 are shaded. So the answer is 3/8. Where we got it 3/8? Yes, so circle this number. Now, how many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 are shaded. So where we got it 4/7? Yes. Now, come to the next one. 1, 2. How many are shaded? 1 part. So answer is 1/2. Here 1/4, 1/2, 3/4. Which is the correct answer? 1/2 is the correct answer. Now come to the next one, children. 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. 3/4. Where we got it 3/4? Here. So circle that number. Next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total 5 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4/5. So where we got it 4/5? Here. Go circle that number. Okay, children, do you understand this class? In this class, we have learned about how to keep the tick marks for the correct fractions and how to keep the circles for the shaded part of the given each shape. Okay, children, in the next class I'll continue some more sums to you. Thank you. Have a nice day.